The latest Hendra outbreak has put flying foxes at the centre of controversy, but one Gold Coast woman is doing everything she can to protect them. Trish Wimberley is making sure the hundreds of animals in her care have a warm jumper this winter.
There are protected species directly linked to the spread of the deadly Hendra virus, which has now travelled as far south as Coffs Harbour. But thanks to Queensland mother of three, Trish Wimberley, hundreds of them are also wearing protective armour of their own.
We cannot afford to lose any more of those.
The wildlife lover from Advancetown in the Gold Coast hinterland has handmade little jackets to keep about 500 grey-headed and black flying foxes warm through winter.
This year there's been a lot of bats coming in with no fur, so we've put the little jackets on them because they feel the cold just like we do.
She also heads up the Hinterlands Australian Bat Clinic and uses the jackets as a way of managing wounded mammals. And this season, Trish says she's treating more injured and sick bats than ever before.
There's not a lot of food around, the cold weather, the floods that we've had, it's been really hard for them.
Despite new calls for bat populations to be culled, Australian scientists are concerned the animal is already so under threat it could be extinct within 30 years.
I think people maybe need to learn a little bit more about the ecology of bats and just how they do work in the environment.
Flying foxes have become the subject of much debate.
It is possible to get a permit to relocate bat colonies where it's appropriate to do so.
But this bat carer of more than 20 years says the winged mammals need our help to survive.
If we were to cull these guys, I mean, we'd suffer dramatically. It's really important that we do save them.
On the Gold Coast, Amber Austin-Wright, 10 News.